Prime Minister Modi has touched down now in Kiev of Ukraine. So anytime now, we're expecting live images of the Prime Minister visiting Kiev for the first time since the war broke out. There will be a meeting, a formal bilateral between Prime Minister Modi and Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky. We are also hearing that Zelensky, in all likelihood, will be accompanying the Prime Minister as he visits several crucial parts of Kiev, taking stock of the situation currently, of how the nation has also been hit as a result of the war with Russia. Now, Prime Minister Modi also on his schedule will be meeting with the Indian diaspora, particularly with students, Indian students, a large delegation of them who are currently based in Ukraine, medical students who the Prime Minister will be meeting. But historic landmark visit this, one, because of the timing that's happening at a time when Ukraine and Russia are at war. Secondly, also because Narendra Modi is now the first Indian Prime Minister to ever touch down on Ukrainian soil. This visit comes just about 6 weeks after Prime Minister Modi was in Russia. So the messaging from India is very, very clear that we don't take sides in a war. We are on the side of peace, and that's why we will urge both sides to end this conflict. Gaurav Sawant is joining us live right now from Kiev, getting us the latest updates. Gaurav, we've just got the confirmation that Prime Minister Modi has touched down in Kiev. Take us through really what's on his agenda. We understand there will be a bilateral with President Zelensky. He's going to be meeting also with the Indian diaspora.
So the Prime Minister actually took an 8-hour-long train journey from Poland to Kiev. And the train has arrived at the railway station, and just moments earlier the Prime Minister crossed this place and he's reached his venue, the hotel where he's interacting with the Indian diaspora. And there were loud chants of Bharat Mata Ki Jai as Prime Minister Narendra Modi entered and started interacting with the Indian diaspora. He's listening to them, he's hearing them, he's actually praising the Indian diaspora for braving this 2 years of 900 days plus of conflict here in Ukraine, and being that human bridge, being that bond. Each and every Indian who stayed here during war, worked with the people here in Ukraine, they are true ambassadors of India-Ukraine relationship. That's the interaction that the Prime Minister is having here. He'll be interacting with Indologists. You know, India Today is the only channel that's actually interviewed the people that Prime Minister is interacting with, whether it's the Bharatnatyam dancers, the Kalbelia dancers, the Kuchipuri dancers, the little school children who speak Hindi, the diaspora here, the Prime Minister interacting with them. He's accompanied by the External Affairs Minister and the National Security Advisor, Foreign Secretary. So it's a big Indian delegation that will shortly now be moving, and it'll begin the day by garlanding the statue of Mahatma Gandhi, father of the nation. That message of peace and non-violence during India's freedom struggle, equally important today. And then the bread and butter part, the nuts and bolts part of this visit begins, the interaction with President Zelensky and his team. Now that is very critical, that conversation that will last several hours. The Prime Minister will also be interacting with members of parliament and other leaders here in Ukraine. That conversation, Akshita, is all about two aspects. One, not the era of war. We have to find a negotiated peaceful settlement through diplomacy. That diplomacy is not possible as long as there is fighting that is on. Therefore, one, peace. Two, negotiation. Three, that Ukraine insists on fair and just negotiation and settlement, which should not be one-sided. Peace cannot be at Russia's terms. It has to be on a win-win both for Russia and Ukraine. So that's that aspect. But equally important as far as India is concerned, reconstruction of Ukraine and India-Ukraine ties being taken forward altogether to a new level, Akshita.
Very, very true, Gaurav. And this visit, of course, will be watched by the global community also very, very closely. It's coming 6 weeks after Prime Minister Modi was also in Russia, met with President Putin. And the messaging here is very, very clear from India that we want the conflict to end, that we're on the side of peace.
You're absolutely right. In fact, Akshita, you know, I was reporting from Moscow. I was covering Prime Minister's trip on the 8th of July when that missile struck here in Ukraine and hit a hospital, a cancer rehabilitation hospital, and a number of people were killed there. I visited that hospital and I've reported from there. The people here are hurt beyond words. the casualties. Officially, they don't give out numbers, but thousands and thousands massacred in 910 days of conflict on either side of the border. What's the way forward? India is saying, start saving lives on both sides. Two, this is impacting not just Russia and Ukraine, but it's impacting prices across Europe. It's not just impacting the countries in Europe. It's impacting adversely the global south, the developing countries. Ukraine is the breadbasket of Europe. Grain from Ukraine, sunflower oil from Ukraine, gas from Ukraine, fuel from Ukraine, and this region. It goes to all, to India, to Africa, to developing countries, and oil prices, food prices, grain prices, they've skyrocketed. They're adversely impacting the world. They're adversely impacting development in the world. And that is why this war needs to stop and needs to stop immediately. So that's the message that India carries. This war is not just about Russia and Ukraine. This war is about impacting global economy adversely. This war is about impacting the global south adversely. That is why this war must come to an end. What are concrete proposals? Remember, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in his interaction with President Putin, there were only the two of them on that table for over 5 hours. They had certain discussions. That's only in the mind of President Putin and Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Now Prime Minister Narendra Modi comes on the other side and interacts with President Zelensky. What will those ideas be? What will those solutions be? Will something tangible emerge today itself? Or will it be work in progress over the next several weeks and months? That remains to be seen. That is something that the entire world is watching with bated breath, because this war is not benefiting anyone except perhaps the arms industry.
The world perhaps is also looking to India to play a big role in perhaps ending this conflict, considering that we are on the talking table with both Russia and Ukraine. And the Prime Minister has indicated that also in the last few weeks. Thanks very much, Gaurav. Live images right now coming in of Prime Minister Modi on the streets of Kyiv in Ukraine, having taken a train from Poland. The Prime Minister is now on Ukrainian soil. We're expecting him and those images to come in any moment now of the Prime Minister coming out of that particular building. Now, it's expected that he will be meeting with Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky. There will be, of course, a very, very crucial bilateral. But besides that, as we've been seeing in the last many months, when any world leader touches down in Kyiv, President Zelensky also essentially takes them on a tour of the capital to also show them what the impact of the war has been. Now, the exact details and schedule of the Prime Minister's visit to Kyiv is not known just yet, and that is due to security reasons as well. But right now, the Prime Minister's reached Kyiv essentially, having taken a train from Poland, and he's expected to emerge from that building anytime now. You can see the kind of security arrangements also that have been put in place for the Prime Minister's visit. Now, he's also very importantly going to be meeting with the Indian diaspora, who've also been suffering the consequences of this conflict, suffering the consequences of this war. We'll keep our cameras focused on these images, because any time now we're expecting to see the first glimpse of Prime Minister Modi there in Kyiv. And it is expected that President Zelensky will meet him immediately after. This is a one-day visit by the Prime Minister, but one that's loaded with significance and symbolism. There's no doubt that the Prime Minister will be putting forth a message of peace, and he's already set the tone for that with the kind of messaging that he put forth in Poland as well. While speaking in Warsaw, the Prime Minister said that this isn't the era of war, that there must be constructive dialogue that will ensure this conflict comes to an end. And like I said earlier, the global community is looking largely to India to play a significant role in ensuring that this conflict comes to an end. And that's because we're in fact in talks and have a dialogue process currently underway with both Russia and Ukraine. And those are the images. Looks like that's the convoy in which Prime Minister Modi could be traveling and visiting parts of Kyiv. He is going to be taking stock of what the impact of the war has been on Kyiv, on Ukrainians, to understand firsthand what this conflict has really meant for the people of Ukraine, who've suffered massive losses. And the Prime Minister is sending across a message on behalf of India that we stand firmly in solidarity with Ukraine, while also beseeching both countries to end this conflict. And India has managed to essentially delicately balance diplomacy on both fronts with regards to this conflict, saying very clearly we don't take sides in a war and that we are only on the side of peace, which is why this visit is extremely crucial and the timing of it. It's happening just 6 weeks after the Prime Minister visited Russia, had those talks with President Putin. And while there were many, who criticized India, who criticized the Prime Minister for meeting with Putin, these images that are coming in now from Ukraine puts and sets the record straight as to where exactly India stands, that we're neither on the side of Russia or Ukraine, we're on the side of peace, we're on the side of dialogue and diplomacy to put an end to this conflict. For 7 hours, Prime Minister Modi will be in Kyiv. It's a one-day visit, one that's extremely important. We're going to continue getting you all the images that come in from Kyiv. As it looks like now, the Prime Minister's convoy, the motorcade, is making its way through the streets of the capital city of Ukraine.